Can you all hear me? I'm Carolyn Benetton, Director of Public Affairs at the Consulate General of Israel. Welcome to tonight's historic event celebrating 25 years of diplomatic relations between the Republic of Azerbaijan and the State of Israel. Now, please rise for the national anthems sung by cantor Marcus Feldman of Sinai Temple.
Thank you.
it is my distinct pleasure to bring to the stage the Max Webb Senior Rabbi of Sinai Temple, David Wolpe.
Thank you. It was wonderful to see those pictures because it recalls our trip to Azerbaijan. And what struck me about the trip was that when I came back and I published an article saying what we had experienced, and really just talking about what we had in fact experienced, all sorts of people started writing in complaining about it. And it taught me a very important lesson. First of all, we know that both Israel and Azerbaijan share one feature that is unenviable. They're both in tough neighborhoods, right? But the other thing is that there are people on both sides of the political divide who I think don't understand what it feels like in the world when you don't have the embrace of the international community to find a nation that embraces you, and how important that is, and what a lifeline that is. But our own experience to walk on the streets of any country, much less a Muslim country, wearing a kippah, which I did the whole time we were there, and not to have a single person look askance, not one bad look, nothing but friendship, nothing but kindness. To walk into a synagogue in any country in the world, much less a Muslim country, where there was no security, I couldn't believe it. I thought they probably took out the metal detectors just for us. But then I talked to the people in the synagogue. They said, no, it's like this all the time. That is, for people who travel in the world, an almost unique experience, and a beautiful one. As I traveled from Tel Aviv to Baku, because we went to Israel first, the plane that I took was filled with people who were going from Tel Aviv to Baku. And it was really a joyous experience, and a wonderful experience, not just to connect with the Jews of Azerbaijan, not just to bring a Torah to a Jewish community that needed one. That would have been enough, really. That would have been, as we say in our Passover Seder, Dayenu. Had we only done that, everybody would have been happy. But some of the best connections were with the people of Azerbaijan themselves. Not just the Jewish community, but the non-Jewish community, the Muslim community, the community of leaders, the people whom we met who were government officials. And it made the trip really unique because it was no longer a sightseeing tour alone, although we saw some wonderful and remarkable things. It also really was a hand of friendship extended not just from Israel to Azerbaijan, but from the Jewish community to Azerbaijan and Azerbaijan back to the Jewish community. So when I came back, and I wrote this up, and I was so happy that we had this experience, and all of a sudden, on all the social media, people started to say, you know, but why don't you care about this, and why don't you criticize that, on both sides, by the way, not just in Azerbaijan, in Israel. I thought there is a fundamental principle in Jewish law, which I'm sure exists in the law of every religion, but again, I don't speak all three languages. It's called hakarat hatov. It means gratitude when someone is good to you. And so to come back and not say, this is how good the country was to us, is to fail in a fundamental commandment, a fundamental mitzvah, and also in our humanness. So to celebrate the relationship between Israel and Azerbaijan is a wonderful thing, not just politically and in terms of trade and all of those things, but really as a model for people, that your backgrounds can be different and your regions can be different and your histories can be different, and it is still not impossible to walk into each other's homes and to be welcome. That's what I know everybody on our trip felt, and for that, we say thank you.
Thank you.
Consul General of Israel, Sam Grundwerg. Moderator for tonight's discussion was recently appointed director of the American Jewish Committee's Los Angeles office. Before that, he held the position of director of the Jess Unruh Institute of Politics at the University of Southern California. Ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome for our moderator, Dan Schnur.
First of all, I want to thank all of you for joining us tonight. In just a moment, I'm going to ask both of our consuls general to tell you all a little bit about themselves. But before I do, if I can take just a moment of editorial privilege and moderator's privilege, and on behalf of the Jewish community of Los Angeles, and on behalf of the Jewish community of this country and internationally, please join me in thanking these two remarkable men for the public service they provide for us. If ever there was a time in our own country's history, and internationally as well, when we needed to be reminded that differences of cultures and differences of backgrounds didn't need to be obstacles, but could instead be opportunities, didn't need to be points of divisiveness, but opportunities for peace and mutual respect, now is that time. And the two gentlemen we have here with us tonight on behalf of their respective nations exemplify that commitment to overcoming differences, to take on common obstacles, to create common opportunities. And we're very, very lucky to have them both with us. Before I ask them to tell you more about themselves, I'm going to point out one more thing that deserves some respect and some regard, if you don't mind me saying so, some applause. The fact that there are, by my rough count, more than 300 members of the community gathered tonight for this conversation speaks extraordinarily well, not just of these two nations and of these two men, but of our community as well. And so for all of you who've gathered tonight to be part of this vital conversation, let's start the evening by giving yourselves a round of applause. Because I also want to join the others in thanking Rabbi Wolpe and the entire Sinai Temple community. And there are too many people here to thank and to acknowledge by name. So at this point, I'm going to do the best thing that a moderator can do, is quiet down and let our featured guests of the evening begin to talk. So I'm going to start with General Aghayev. In our country, custom is the visiting team goes first. And so Nasimi, I'd ask you, before we get to the broader conversations and the topics at hand, if you'd be willing to take a couple minutes and tell the group that's gathered here tonight a little bit about yourself, not just as a diplomat, but as a human being.
Thank you very much, Dan. I would like also to take the opportunity to thank everyone who've come to this event. It's such a pleasure to see so many familiar faces, great friends, but also new faces. And also the Sinai Temple for opening its doors again and again to events, celebrating this great friendship between Azerbaijan and Israel, but also between our two peoples, between Azerbaijan and Jewish peoples. The journey that Rabbi Wolpe mentioned was a remarkable one, and I was happy enough and privileged enough to accompany the whole 45-50 men and women delegation to Azerbaijan during their remarkable trip there, and I see many members of that delegation today joining us here. And this relationship that started the Sinai Temple is a very precious one for us, and that's what we appreciate a lot. Thank you very much, and thank you thanks a lot to Rabbi Wolpe for his leadership and for his friendship and for his remarkable team here. Also, many thanks to the Consul General for co-hosting this event with us here at the Sinai Temple. And last but not least, it's not a coincidence that the newly minted regional director of the American Jewish Community of Los Angeles is moderating this event, because AJC has historically, during the last 25 years almost, not only contributed to the strong relationship between the Jewish communities of Azerbaijan and the United States, but also to the strong relationship between Azerbaijan and Israel. Every year, the executive director of the AJC, the national executive director of the AJC, Mr. David Harris, takes a delegation to Azerbaijan every February or March, a national delegation, and he actually received a friendship order from our president, the order that's given to foreign nationals, and the highest honor that a foreign national can get from Azerbaijan. So this is a very special relationship with AJC. Thanks for moderating. Thank you very much. And without, after this long introduction, let me back to your question about myself. I grew up in a country that's very multicultural. And actually, the things that we're doing today are our parts of our lifestyle, have always been parts of our lifestyle in Azerbaijan. Growing up with people of different backgrounds, ethnicities, and religions has always been a blessing for all of us. And then I joined diplomacy 18 years ago, diplomatic service, serving in Europe, in Germany, Austria, and some years in Washington, D.C. at our embassy. And 5 years ago, I was privileged to be appointed by our president as Consul General to Los Angeles. And when you look back, it's been 5 years, a long time, but actually it was like this. But I think it has been a very rewarding experience, and I'm happy that we've been able to establish these beautiful relationships in Los Angeles. Thank you.
Let the record show that Consul General Nasimi Aghayev spent much more time thanking us than telling us about himself. But I think we'll let that pass for at least this round. Let's turn now to Consul General Sam Grundwerg. And Sam, we're so happy to have you with us tonight, not just as a representative of the State of Israel, but on behalf of everything you've done as part of our community here. It means a great deal to us. We're thrilled to have you with us here tonight. Thank you for being here. Maybe you can tell us, on the off chance there's someone in the audience who doesn't know that much about you, maybe you can fill in those blanks for us.
Thank you, Dan. First of all, it's a really honor and privilege to be with all of you tonight, and I want to join in what Dan said, and first of all, recognizing all of you from the community leaders for being here, my colleagues from the Diplomatic Corps. Thank you very much, and of course, to Sinai Temple. I also want to echo and take this opportunity, Dan, to thank you and to wish you, on behalf of the State of Israel and my colleague here and all of us in the community, great success in your new position here as a director of the AJC here in Los Angeles. And thank you very much. We wish you good luck. I also want to note that for all intents and purposes, we are both the home team for this event. There's no home and away team. And it's really great to sit up here with my friend and colleague, who I also wanted to mention was so modest that he forgot to say until the very end even a word about himself. It's really great to be able to come out here this evening together and with the community to celebrate this great relationship. As Dan mentioned, I've had the opportunity already to get to know many of you, so I'll keep the remarks on my background very brief. I had the privilege to serve as Consul General for Israel here in Los Angeles since August of last year, so it's been less than a year. I was appointed by Prime Minister Netanyahu in his capacity as Foreign Minister, and so I came from outside of the diplomatic corps, not a career diplomat, but hopefully a professional diplomat. And prior to that, I worked for 6 years and served in the position in Jerusalem as the Executive Director of the World Jewish Congress, working with Jewish communities around the world, and actually had some interaction with the Jewish community from Azerbaijan in my previous capacity, and was reunited with them a few months ago when my colleague, Consul General from Azerbaijan, invited me to join in a meeting with leaders of the Jewish community that came and visited him in his consulate. And so I did that for 6 years. Prior to that, I practiced law in South Florida. I was a transactional real estate lawyer. And I worked in finance before that. So I've done a few different things and had a varied background. I grew up in South Florida. And that's by way of my background. And also, as my colleague mentioned, I would say I grew up in a multicultural atmosphere and environment, and have a real appreciation for the diversity and the friendship. And I think that it's fantastic to be able to join the stage and celebrate together. Thank you.
Tim, I'm going to stick with you for a minute because I do want to ask the question that a relatively uninformed observer of this remarkable relationship would want to ask right at the outset. There's every possible reason in the world that these two countries should not get along. There's every possible potential barrier and point of divisiveness. How does the state of Israel and how does the nation of Azerbaijan overcome those obstacles to form the kind of remarkable relationship that exists?
It's true. I think that's why it is so remarkable and why it's such an important event that we come together to mark this relationship. And there are so many reasons why. You saw in the video when the rabbi spoke about it. First of all, a couple of reasons why one would think that there should be a relationship. First of all, the Jewish community in Azerbaijan goes back a couple of thousand years. And really, even putting the Jewish community aside, the country of Azerbaijan is really a model for tolerance in general, and especially when it comes to the Jewish community. And anti-semitism. The rabbi spoke about that as well in terms of the feeling of being able to walk around and to have a Muslim country with a flourishing Jewish community which is officially supported with great friendship by the government of Azerbaijan is such a unique thing. And as you mentioned, Dan, there are so many reasons on paper why one would think that there would not necessarily be close relations. And what has turned out in the very short time, really 25 years, when we think about it, I was just talking with my colleague from Germany, we celebrated 50 years of diplomatic relations. 25 years, really such a short time. And to be able to develop such a close relationship, and it's really become a strategic partnership. On the one hand, Israel is still a young country. We just celebrated 69 years. We have a big round number of 70 coming up next year. So the fact that, first of all, both countries are young, there's a lot that we can learn from one another. And the strategic partnerships between the two countries really have developed, where Azerbaijan was 25 years ago in terms of natural resources and gas. That's where we are today. We've only in Israel, as you know, discovered our natural gas resources a few years ago. And so there's a lot that we have to learn from Azerbaijan. And we're able to share a lot of our knowledge in other areas when it comes to high tech and health besides health and high tech and water and agriculture. And so the bonds have been laid down, and I really think that it started with the 2009